Respected Dr. Mashalkar, Shri Sanjeev Baba, Knight Nimbkar, Dr. Nani Nimbkar, Dr. Channa Nimbkar, ladies and gentlemen. I am honored and delighted that you could come for this function. Celebration of 50 years is a time for remembrance, reflection, introspection, and also to think about the future. From minimal infrastructure when I came back from US in 1981 to having some decent facility now, it has been an interesting journey at NARI. That journey has been written up in an aptly titled book, Romance of Innovation, a human interest story of R&D in rural setting, which was released as an e-book by Dr. Mashalkar in 2014 and is now in physical form. In fact, he will release it in a physical form also. It is available from our institute, and some of you are interested can take it. Now, as I reflect back, I remember that working and setting up a renewable energy lab in a small rural town in 1981 was not easy. The institute at the time consisted of a small building and farms with minimum infrastructure. I got an old fan fitted in my office, and that was the only fan in the whole institute. Besides, one rarely had electricity, so the fan was mostly non-functional. Telecommunication facilities were almost non-existent in those times, and it was a nightmare to make a long-distance phone call to any place. One had to book a call in the early morning, and if one was lucky, the call would materialize by evening. So quite a few times, when I needed to make an urgent or important call, I would hop on the bus and go to my friend's office in Pune to make phone calls. The bus journey in those times took about 4 hours one way. In the early days of setting up my lab, it was very difficult to get good engineers and scientists. It took me nearly 4 years to make the lab functional and hire decent staff. Even now, there is a tremendous problem in getting good staff. Even the situation has become worse because we cannot compete with the very high pay packets being offered by industry and the government. However, there was a janoon to do something interesting, and it provided the momentum to carry forward our R&D. Thus, with minimum staff, infrastructure, and limited budget, we have been able to do reasonably good work with lots of innovations and firsts to our name. These are listed in the highlights of the search page in the souvenir that you will have. One of the unique innovations has been of doing R&D on a shoestring budget. I think good research can be done by thinking deeply about the problems, and one can extract a huge amount of information from simple but clever experiments. We have shown this in our lab, where we were able to accomplish the entire R&D work on renewable energy from 1981 till the present in a total budget of less than 2.5 crores. And I think, to my mind, that is the real romance of innovation. One example of this thinking was how NARI was instrumental in formulating a national policy on energy self-sufficient talukas. In 1990, we received a small grant of rupees 3 lakhs from ICICI under USAID PACET program. This grant was given to explore the possibility of making a plan for taluka to become energy self-sufficient. This was based upon our idea that agricultural residues produced in a taluka can power biogas-based power plants to produce all the electricity demands of the taluka. So in 1990, we did a study on the total amount of agricultural residues produced in Phaltan taluka, and then I and my colleague, and he's here, Rajiv, where are you? Rajiv is sitting here. We both went to US to look at nearly one dozen biomass-based power plants. Incidentally, Rajiv learned a lot of very good things. He's now the vice president of Bajaj Auto, and so he's doing a wonderful work in Bajaj Auto. In late 1980s, US was a pioneer of biomass-based power plants. Armed with this data and knowledge, we wrote a detailed project report and submitted to ICICI in 1992. In 1995, this report set a tone for setting up the national policy on energy self-sufficient talukas, which was done by Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, MNRE. NARI was the principal author of this policy. This policy also paved the way for the national biomass-based power plants. Under the scheme, about 120 power plants were financed in different talukas by IREDA. Incidentally, this policy was the forerunner of Pura program promoted by former President Dr. Abdul Kalam in 2004. The head of PACER program at ICICI was one Shri N.J. Jhaveri, who later on became the Deputy Managing Director of ICICI. I met him in 1997 in a function in Mumbai, and he told me that this is the first time in the history of ICICI that a small NGO with the help of a tiny grant was able to help up set up a national policy. So it was a very proud moment for us. Similarly was the case for our work on electric mobility. We started the program of electric cycle discharge in 1995. At that time, where is Patil? Patil was our main technician who did a lot of work on electric cycle discharge. At that time, this concept was not heard and often somehow caught the fancy of almost everybody. This resulted in our paper on the subject appearing very prominently in 1999 in a journal published by MIT Boston. Besides, our work also elicited excellent publicity in mass media. In those days, good permanent magnet DC motors running on batteries were not available in India. So we got hold of a small PMDC manufacturer in Pune who designed a motor for us. We gave him feedback on the loading characteristics of the motor by the use of very innovative method. Two of us, Patil was one of them, and my technician Pawar, would sit in the electric rickshaw with an ammeter and voltmeter attached to the motor and take reading every half minute as it went on a ride over pothole roads and slopes. These readings for different terrains, speed and duration of drive gave all the data that was needed to redesign the motor. With this data, the manufacturer used to tweak the motor and give us a better one. In 2002, I gave an invited talk at the National Center for Sustainable Transportation in University of California, Davis. And they were amazed at the low-cost, ingenious way we used to collect data. Normally, such data is recorded via very expensive computer-based systems. There are many such examples of innovative, low-cost methods that we developed for producing technologies, and these are listed in the Book of Commands. I feel such methodologies should be taught and practiced in R&D labs, especially those working in rural areas. I have spent 37 years of my life at NARI. In fact, all of my career has been shaped at NARI. As I reflect on those 37 years, they have given me happiness and satisfaction. Two most important goals one should try to achieve in whatever profession one chooses. Satisfaction I have got in doing things that I enjoyed most, namely innovation, and also in spreading the message of Janoon for rural innovations to youngsters in IITs and other colleges, and a good number of interns who have come to NARI from all over the world. Happiness I have felt in exploring the nature of life and spirituality. Working at NARI has allowed me to do innovative thinking on the interaction of spirituality and technology, and helped me realize that the mantra of India's and mankind progress could be spirituality plus technology is equal to happiness. Spirituality allows us to curb our greed, and with the help of high technology, allows us to live a holistic, sustainable, and emotionally satisfying life. This is an area in which I have written extensively and would like to explore and study further. We propose to have workshops and seminars on this theme during our Golden Jubilee year. Similarly, we would like to also conduct workshops, lectures, training sessions on sustainability issues for students and managers. I give lectures on sustainability in various IITs and engineering colleges. We hope to have a series of these events here at NARI during the Golden Jubilee year to educate students in various skills and also to train them to be good citizens. This brings me to the last part. What should our future strategy be? From the experience gained, I feel that the future roadmap for NARI can be as follows. First, Indian farming is in crisis. Farming is non-remunerative and farmers do not want to farm. There is a need to modernize it and make it remunerative. Precision agriculture and continuous agriculture may help in doing this. We hope to start a serious effort in both these areas, especially for fodder production. Together with this is the processing of farm produce. Thus, NARI is developing a completely mechanized sweet sorghum syrup plant and setting up a solar-powered coal press for extraction of oil from oil seeds. Both these technologies, we hope, will help in increasing the remuneration to the farmers. Two Bajaj fellows, one Rahul Pisharavati and other is Shubham Sharma, are working on them. Last week, I was invited to be the chief guest of Ignite 2018 program at IIT Gandhinagar. Interacting with Dr. Sudhir Jain, an old friend of mine, the dynamic IIT Gandhinagar director, and other faculty members, I got a feeling that IIT Gandhinagar is very serious in creating innovations for high-tech agriculture. In fact, we are exploring Dr. Mashulkar with him about the use collaboration on few projects on the use of drones in agriculture systems. Number two, explore the possibility of multiplying NARI type rural science and technology NGOs. The problems that exist in rural areas should be solved through the innovation and R&D by rural-based science and technology NGOs. How do you develop an ecosystem in the country to do this? This will also be the subject of various workshops, talks and seminars. Somehow the government labs or institutions of higher learning or corporations have not been successful in doing that. I feel a healthy cooperation of science and technology NGOs like ours with national labs, institutes and corporates might help in this endeavor. Today we have with us Dr. Mashulkar, the guru of innovation and also a member of so many prominent companies of this country. I will request his help in exploring the possibility of how this idea could be taken forward either through the government or as a part of CSR activities. Since there are brilliant minds in this hall today, we will be delighted to get suggestions on what we should do in the future. We can discuss this over lunch and after lunch. I again thank you all for coming to this function. Thank you very much.